Unmasking HIV, recognizing the telltale signs in men. Hello guys. Welcome back to Mark Medicals. Did you know that there are some of the HIV signs that only occur in men or women? Yes, it's true. Some symptoms only occur in men, and this video explains the common 7. If you are in hurry, a common sign of HIV is painful open sores or ulcers on your mouth or esophagus. They can also appear on your anus or genitals. These sores often keep coming back. In the remaining part of this video, I will explain the following 7 signs of HIV that only occur in men like 1. Pain during intercourse. 2. Peeing more often than usual. 3. Cloudy or bloody pee. 4. Pain in the bladder, genitals, or rectum. 5. Less hair growth on the body and face. 6. Breast tissue growth, and 7. Sores on the penis. 8. Other symptoms that occur in both men and women. Toward the end of the video, I will tell you other signs of HIV that occur in both men and women. So, watch this video till the end to learn many things. Before I start, HIV is a virus that can look different in each person, and not everyone will have the same set of symptoms, and some may not have any signs for a long time. However, there are some telltale signs of HIV in men that can be recognized. Here are some of the symptoms specific to men. 1. Painful intercourse. Painful intercourse, also known as dysorgasmia or orgasmalgia, can range from mild discomfort to severe pain during or after intercourse. Pain may occur during or following intercourse and may be located in the genitals, bladder, or rectum. Painful intercourse can also happen as a result of prostate disorders, medication, sexually transmitted infections or STIs, and more. Some men feel embarrassed when intercourse is painful, but it is a relatively common symptom. Painful intercourse is not dangerous, but it can undermine a man's quality of life. Men who experience painful intercourse may also report a loss of interest in sex, shame, relationship issues, self-esteem issues, and fertility concerns. Painful intercourse is usually a symptom of a larger problem that needs to be treated. Underlying diseases, such as diabetes and MS, must also be addressed. 2. Peeing more often than usual. Peeing more often than usual can be a sign of HIV in men. This symptom can occur due to inflammation and infection in the urethra and bladder. HIV can also cause damage to the kidneys, which can lead to increased urination. Peeing more often than usual can also be a symptom of other sexually transmitted infections, STIs, such as gonorrhea and chlamydia. It is important to note that peeing more often than usual can also be a symptom of other conditions such as diabetes, prostate problems, and urinary tract infections. 3. Cloudy or bloody pee. Cloudy or bloody pee can be a sign of prostatitis, which is inflammation of the prostate gland, and can be a symptom of HIV in men. This symptom can also be caused by other conditions such as urinary tract infections, kidney stones, and bladder cancer. If you are experiencing this symptom, it is important to see a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause and receive appropriate treatment. 4. Pain in the bladder, balls, or rectum. Pain in the bladder, balls, or rectum can be a sign of HIV in men. This symptom can occur due to inflammation and infection in the urethra, bladder, prostate gland, or rectum. HIV can also cause damage to the nerves that supply the bladder, which can lead to pain. Pain in the balls can be a symptom of epididymitis, which is inflammation of the epididymis, a tube located at the back of the balls. Pain in the shaft can be a symptom of prostatitis, which is inflammation of the prostate gland. Pain in the rectum can be a symptom of proctitis, which is inflammation of the rectum. It is important to note that pain in these areas can also be a symptom of other conditions such as urinary tract infections, prostate problems, and sexually transmitted infections. If you are experiencing this symptom, it is important to see a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause and receive appropriate treatment. 5. Less hair growth on the body and face. Less hair growth on the body and face can be a sign of HIV in men. This symptom can occur due to damage to the hair follicles caused by the virus. HIV can also cause hormonal imbalances that can lead to hair loss. It is important to note that less hair growth on the body and face can also be a symptom of other conditions such as aging, genetics, and hormonal imbalances. If you are experiencing this symptom, it is important to see a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause and receive appropriate treatment. 6. Breast tissue. Breast tissue growth can be a sign of HIV in men. This symptom can occur due to hormonal imbalances caused by the virus. HIV can cause a decrease in testosterone levels and an increase in estrogen levels, which can lead to breast tissue growth. Breast tissue growth can also be a side effect of some medications used to treat HIV. It is important to note that breast tissue growth can also be a symptom of other conditions such as gynecomastia, which is a benign enlargement of the male breast tissue. If you are experiencing this symptom, it is important to see a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause and receive appropriate treatment. 7. Sores on the man's shaft. Sores on the shaft can be a sign of HIV in men. These sores can be painful and may be accompanied by other symptoms such as discharge, itching, and burning. Sores on the shaft can be caused by sexually transmitted infections, STIs, such as herpes, syphilis, and chancroid. HIV weakens the immune system, making it easier for other infections to take hold and cause sores. It is important to note that sores on the shaft can also be a symptom of other conditions such as skin infections, allergic reactions, and injuries. If you are experiencing this symptom, it is important to see a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause and receive appropriate treatment. Other symptoms that occur in both men and women. There are other symptoms that aren't exclusive to men but are important to keep an eye on. Within 4 weeks of when you become infected, a flu-like illness can arrive. This is your body's natural response to the HIV infection. It can last anywhere from a few days to several months. You might have fever, headache, fatigue, sore throat, skin rash, swollen lymph glands, diarrhea, night sweats, and aching muscles or joints. Experts call this stage acute or primary HIV infection. It's when the HIV virus enters certain types of white blood cells. It makes billions of copies of itself, spreading throughout the body. During this time, you have a higher chance of transmitting the virus to other people because there are large amounts of the virus in your bodily fluids. After HIV wins against your immune system, it spreads at a slower rate. This stage is called chronic or clinical latency. In many cases, you won't have any more symptoms. Without treatment, HIV can lead to AIDS.